We're now shifting our attention to Jammu and Kashmir, where finally, after several weeks of intense negotiations, the Bharatiya Janata Party and the PDP announced that they would form a government together. Mufti Mohammad Saeed will be taking oath once more on Sunday as the Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir. The BJP and the PDP, though, are not telling us just yet what the consensus is. What is the solution on Article 370? What will happen to talks with the Hurriyat? Will it have a bearing on talks with Pakistan? They're very tight-lipped about it. They're saying, wait for the common minimum program. But Mufti met Modi this morning, and here's what happened.
It was this visit by the PDP mentor Mufti Mohammad Saeed to the Prime Minister's residence at 7 RCR which sealed the deal between two parties. A hug and a 70-minute-long chai pe charcha between the two, bringing 2 months of intense talks between the PDP and the BJP to a successful conclusion.
मैं हिस्ट्री को दोहराना चाहता हूँ. आज हिंदुस्तान के भारत के जो प्रधानमंत्री हैं, उनको लोगों का मंडेट हासिल है. He has got full legitimacy to deliver. मुझे बड़ा हाथ चाहिए, सबका विकास, सबका साथ.
The meeting finalized the common minimum program, which will be released on Sunday after the swearing in. Other details: Mufti will be the chief minister with BJP getting the deputy CM's post. According to sources, 13 PDP and 12 BJP MLAs will be sworn in as ministers. BJP has reportedly demanded home, finance and PWD ministries.
देखिए जो हमारा agenda for alliance है उसमें political इश्यूज के अलावा इकोनॉमिक इश्यूज, डेवलपमेंट, सब की बातें हैं. आप मेहरबानी करके सिर्फ एक तारीख तक इंतजार कर लीजिए.
Senior leaders of the PDP off camera acknowledge that amidst allegations of a sell-out alliance, acceptability of its tie-up with the BJP will remain a big challenge. For the BJP, growth and governance are common achievables, but issues including AFSPA and the PDP's self-rule documents, which for now seemingly sorted, will remain the bones of contention and continue to be the litmus test for this alliance, especially given how sensitive the valley can be. In New Delhi, with Brijesh Pandey and video journalist Amit Kumar, this is Smita Sharma for Headlines Today.
Let's now go across to the BJP headquarters. Joining us from there is senior BJP leader Ram Madhav. He's one of the key architects of this alliance. He's been at it for several weeks now, and finally you've been able to put this together. So that's commendable, given how unlikely it seemed at various stages. But Ram Madhav, tell me this right at the start. There are no two parties in India which can be as politically different from each other as the BJP and the PDP. You've made this alliance happen. But do you believe it's fraught with so many contradictions that this is an alliance that is bound to fail? There is a landmine at every turn and you never know which one's going to blow up on your face.
We are going ahead with hope and confidence. We have come together to deliver some developmental agenda for the state of Jammu and Kashmir. We are confident that we will be able to do what is mandated by people.
Suggesting that there is no compromise, but you know, I've been speaking to a whole host of people in the Sangh Parivar, and if you speak to them, there is a sense, especially amongst the low level cadre, the Swayam Sevaks, the Pracharaks, that this seems to be a compromise at the altar of power. That because the BJP was keen on getting a toehold in Jammu and Kashmir, you've compromised on your core ideology of Article 370, Mr. Madhav.
See, firstly, had it been about compromising, there would have been a government 2 months ago, you must remember. The whole effort in last 2 months was to make sure that on important political issues where we both parties have traditionally held different viewpoints, we come to an understanding, we find some common ground and we articulate it. It is that effort which took this long, which took almost 8 weeks, And I can tell you, you will see in 2 days from now when the common minimum program is released, that it's not about compromises. It's about protecting the interests of the people of the state of Jammu and Kashmir as well as the interests of our whole country. No question of any compromises by either side. Having said it, you are the people who have been speculating without knowing what is there in CMP. You are going on speculating and talking about compromises, this and that. Wait for CMP to come out.
No, but are you then suggesting, Ram Madhav, that there is no compromise on Article 370? Because since the time of Deen Dayal Upadhyay, the idea of abrogating Article 370 has been at the very core of what the RSS stands for. Now, suddenly, 370 is no longer as much of an agenda. Are you then telling us that when this CMP comes out, the RSS and the BJP stance will be seen in this common minimum program? Because that's not what our sources are telling us.
What we say in common minimum program, you wait till the afternoon of 1st of March. Then we can meet and discuss about what we said and whether it is a compromise or not.
I, in fact, will be traveling to Jammu, so I will take you up on that after the common minimum program is put out. I will ask you deeper questions about Article 370 because that really is something the BJP needs to answer, especially to its own core voters on. Let's now come to dialogue with the Hurriyat. The PDP has been insisting that dialogue with the Hurriyat is a must. You can't go away from it. The BJP doesn't want to talk to the Hurriyat. So what do you do with the Hurriyat, which will sit in the Srinagar city every single day? The PDP wants to talk to them. You don't want to talk to them. How will you deal with them, Ram Madhav?
Except that we have clearly articulated our position on that issue in our common minimum program. I won't disclose what the actual content of the statement was.
You're being very, very guarded in all your responses this evening. I'm seeing that. But what about Pakistan? Because on Pakistan, the government's position has been that no talks till terror continues, camps are still existing, Hafiz Saeed is still there. Will domestic politics now have a bearing on foreign policy and what India does with Pakistan?
No, there is no question of being guarded. You are in a hurry. You should have waited till the CMP is out before shooting these questions to me. And you want to gamble on speculations, what can I do? CMP will be released on 1st of March. Then all your questions are relevant. Today they are irrelevant.
No. The questions are still very relevant. You may choose not to answer them. But the questions are as relevant today as they will be on Sunday. But let's, because some people would say, Mr. Madhav, that the foreign secretary goes to Islamabad just days after the new government is formed in Jammu and Kashmir. Now, this can't surely be a coincidence. Both these things have been happening for weeks now, the building up to a new government in Jammu and Kashmir, and your critics will allege that you took a certain position on Pakistan, you boxed yourself into a corner, now unilaterally you're trying to find a way out, and that's not good diplomacy.
Foreign Secretary's visit was decided much before we finally decided that this arrangement will work. We came to a final conclusion that yes, we would be able to come together to run a government on a CMP only day before yesterday, late in the night. Until then, we were working on various aspects of CMP. And whereas foreign minister's visit was decided at least 1 week back.
No, but this is a stretched argument. Both things have been happening parallelly, so you can't say that one is not linked to the other. Are you then, through what you're telling our viewers, suggesting that foreign policy will not be impacted at all by domestic politics? Because at the end of the day, all diplomacy at the end of it comes down to domestic politics. If you've got a government in Jammu and Kashmir where Mufti Mohammad Saeed might have huge problems if you decide to cancel talks with Pakistan, surely at some level those are issues that could play a role in determining what the government does with Pakistan.
Foreign policy is completely a prerogative of the union government. What we are forming is a government for the state of Jammu and Kashmir.
Sir, but two parties cannot be as politically different from each other as the BJP and the PDP. And given the fact that these two parties are so ideologically opposed to each other, what is it that you are going to do to assuage the concerns on both sides of the mountains? You've got people in Jammu were concerned about the PDP. People in the valley very suspicious of the BJP. What is it that you promised them? How will this government that is built on so many contradictions actually come together, sir?
All those concerns will be alleviated. Number one, there was a mandate which left us with no other option but to come together. We decided that we have a responsibility to respect that mandate of the people, come together. Now, the only objective with which we decided to come together and work together was to give a good government to the state of Jammu and Kashmir, a government that is non-corrupt like the previous ones, that is focused on development, unlike the previous governments, which were focused about all other issues except the development of the state. It will be a focused government on development of the state. We have certain issues, especially certain political issues, on which we do not see eye to eye. It is agreed. Mufti Saab has himself stated in one of the interviews that we are like North Pole and South Pole. On those issues, we took a pragmatic view without compromising on our stated positions. For the sake of giving a stable and strong government, a development-oriented government to the state, we came together.